Hello, ladies and gentlemen of the internet. Welcome to another episode of the Musing with Menchaca show. This is the conversational podcast where four friends gather around these microphones, each with their own random topics of discussion to hash out for your amusement. If you like this video, give us a thumbs up, share us with your friends, and subscribe for more content. I am your host, Luis Menchaca, and be a part of the conversation. Comment below with any suggestions for topics. God damn it. Reactions to anything that's said or feedback for the show. Let's see. You can follow me on Twitter. I'm at Chocolaca88. PS. Yeah, can I say that right? Chocolaca88. Whatever. PSN, Nintendo Network, XBL, Twitch, all Chocolaca88, all across the board. Easy to remember. And if 140 characters are not enough for you, I understand. You can email me boomchocolaca4@gmail.com for anything long form you want addressed on the show. This is episode 33 of the Musing with the Chocolate Show. So joining me today, we got two newcomers to the series. But to my right, we have the apparatus, Christian.
Hey guys, welcome. I'm back again.
Yeah, all right. The veteran, I guess, in this case.
But the veteran. No, I've only been. This is my second one.
This is your second one. It is, isn't it? Okay, yeah. Well, that by comparison,
more
they're
experience.
Rookies.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. All right. You know how podcasting works. Yeah. All right. Next to him, one of the newcomers, we got the champion Clemente.
Hello, my name's Clemente, and I guess my nickname is Chlamydia, so that's not a good one for me, so.
Okay, you gotta explain that one after we're done with that.
Okay, well.
All right, and rounding out the table, we have, the hair?
Yeah.
Yes. Let's go with the hair. Okay, the hair, Israel.
Hello, I'm Israel, and I'm gonna win Smash or Pass 2016.
Now, rewind two episodes ago, this guy over here called you a bitch.
Yeah.
And he challenged you to Smash or Pass 2016.
Yeah. So we better be somewhere in the middle. Like, we're going to meet somewhere in the middle, and I'm just going to kick his ass.
You're going to go down. You're going to go down right away.
Okay.
You're not going to make it past round one.
Okay.
Just like you?
Just like you. Yeah.
You know what? I'm Smash or Pass 2015 champion trios. Luis Menchaca.
I didn't get to stay that long, so I couldn't kick your ass. So.
Ooh.
Yes. All right. So let's see here. Oh, yes. One last thing about that is make sure you can follow the link in the description below for the iTunes if you want to listen to us while you multitask and work out or whatever. Because I got some people saying, oh, yeah, I like to work out and listen to podcasts. Okay. Yeah, it's all there. All when the entire show posts at the end of the week. So let's see here. Before we get on topics, though, I got to make sure we reiterate this all the time. But this episode of Musing with Menchaca is brought to you by Smash or Pass 2016. Smash or Pass is a Smash Brothers tournament series that I co-host here on my Twitch channel, twitch.tv/chocolaca88. It's going to be on June 18th. Make sure you follow me on Twitter for the latest updates as well. We got former Smash or Pass champion Clemente over here, / runner-up Israel. So it's going to be a good one. We're going to talk about that here momentarily, but let's see here. There's really nothing else left to plug. Nothing really else left to plug. I think I pretty much said it.
Yeah, pretty much.
Okay, so there's really cut the B-roll right here. Just cut it. Cut it. All right. So I wanted to ask you guys. I guess my topic is going to be like two topics in one. It's going to be about Smash or Pass, and it's also going to be about the history of you guys. That's my topic. Mm-hmm. So first off, let's go with Smash or Pass. I want to know, what was it like playing at Grand Finals? What was going through your mind?
What was it like? Just knowing that I had all my fans there to back me up, like, that whole time, just, like, it gave me, I did, like, I pulled an Ike, like, I fight for my friends. Like, I don't do it for anyone else. I don't do it for the money. I almost gave it to charity, but then I didn't, because I didn't want to. But other than that, yeah.
I didn't.
That's what it was like.
Any man would have done the same.
Yeah, I was like,
I mean, I could
do something. Israel, how did it feel like being so close to the championship?
Oh, man. For sure, that last fight was probably the most intense of my life.
That was really good. That was really
good.
But it 3-0 sweep, man. That was terrible, man. You could have. See, here's the thing. First off, it was grand finals, so it was best out of five. Yeah. But you like bounced out a little too early. You should have stayed the course, man. You should have been like, nah, ma. I don't have a bedtime anymore. I don't have a bedtime anymore. I'm a big boy now.
It's not happening this time because I'm an adult now.
Oh, you're
an
adult.
I'm a legal adult.
Okay.
Yeah. All
right. Yeah.
So. Nothing's stopping me now.
Okay, so we're better with coordinating. We know that we're gonna go to 2-stock instead of 3-stock.
Yeah.
Oh, we did 3-stock last time.
Last year, yeah. With 2015, it was 3-stock all the way.
Who were we?
and we were playing on stages that are not tournament legal, but we are now.
Oh, that's right.
We're resetting. We're writing the rules on stage selection, cool. And that's we're gonna have a little ribbons with a little score counter and everything. It's gonna be legit. And I'm working on our commentating game too, so that way it's not like, you know, we're not gonna be like. And
then, yeah.
So we're gonna have more post game interviews. I know that's gonna be the thing. Basically, we're just stepping up the content altogether, like making it all quality, making it look like we're like VG Bootcamp Junior is basically what I'm trying to shoot for.
Pretty much, what we know what we're doing, but we're still done.
But we still.
So yeah, I remember during the Smasher Pass, like the best match was between the two of y'all, and it wasn't Grand Finals; it was Winners Finals. That was the match. That was the most intense thing.
That was really good.
We had a pre-game interview with both of y'all, and everyone was all like crowded around the webcam and everything.
Yeah.
And so I was asking you about, like, you know, what are you gonna do? What are your character choices? Your stage selections? And I remember you were like, "I do it for the fans."
Yeah. Nothing's changed, so.
And you had like the two people that are watching us live, cheering you on, like, "Yay, Clemente!"
That's all I need. That's
like, I know. Wait, but we had one person chanting Israel, though. That's right. I watched the stream. I was trying.
I'm still on one fans.
Well, obviously that person had no morals or values whatsoever. So.
Oh my god. All right, and then what else? But yeah, the best thing was, and then I hate the fact that in the Twitch stream, like it lost, like sometimes with the Twitch streams you lose frames.
Yeah.
You lose frames, and so it lost.
When
frames.
It, like, tipsy would like step on like the cord or something like
no,
that.
No, well that too. Yeah, not just that. It wasn't just stepping on the cord. I meant like during the actual physical stream, frames got dropped. And so the kill that Israel landed for the back throw to kill you.
Oh, I remember that.
It jumped frame. It shouldn't show because it jumped frame. Cut. Like,
man. I was rewatching it the other day, and I was like, oh, and I was like watching my own thing, and I was rooting for myself. And I was like, yes, do the grab. And then it just like blacks out.
It just jumps to the after kill. Yeah. Like when tips.
Like when to everyone like celebrating and stuff.
Yeah, exactly. that was like the worst ever. And that's mostly on the Twitch, YouTube, whatever export process that happened. It wasn't.
Comcast.
Comcast. Charter.
Get that Walmart Wi-Fi.
Get your shit together.
Walmart connection.
So yeah, I think for the cords and stuff, I might just try to tape it down so that way people don't step on it or move it around. I don't know what else to do besides that. And but yeah, it's gonna be interesting. It's gonna be awesome.
Mm-hmm.
I've gotten better.
I think we've all gotten better.
Mm-hmm. I'm glad. I don't know what to expect because I haven't played with y'all in forever. So.
We're bringing in a lot of ringers too.
Yeah,
cool.
Like people who play at tournaments.
Uh-huh.
We're inviting them over.
Really?
Yeah. And then the guy we had a test run with, this one guy last night, and he did beat us, but he didn't like. It wasn't. Clemente.
He didn't destroy.
It
us,
wasn't Clemente yeah. beating. It wasn't oh, okay. like. At, he plays Project M.
Oh. Okay,
and so
yeah.
he wasn't. He was transitioning uh-huh. to Wii U, and like he was still good, but he wasn't like Clemente good, which is terrible. But I want to make sure that we're. By the way, just so you know, Clemente, everyone's rooting against you this year. I know you're like
well,
a sweet
I mean,
guy.
It's only
you're
fair.
You're super
yeah.
humble and everything. You're, but everybody.
I understand.
Nobody
I understand.
Wants you to two-peat.
No, yeah, yeah. Nobody I don't want to either. I'll probably like kill myself. So, you know, everybody
else. So yeah. What else I wanted to talk about? All right, let's go ahead and get to the history of you guys. I want to get to know you. This is a good like nice little candlelit dinner. We're getting to know each other. You know, we're into
wine and dine.
We're gonna wine and dine. I got you some water. It's laced with some whatever. You know, I like long walks on the beach.
Oh my gosh!
But yeah. So first, let's go ahead and get to some video game history. Let's go. How about that? So, what was y'all's first video game consoles? How did y'all grow up? How did y'all become good at games, or just in general? Like, where did y'all start? Let's go with. Israel.
Yeah, I remember my first video game. It was Nintendo 64, and it was like rated C, like Elmo game. I would play it, and I would like get through it like all the time. Like I would start a new one, and I would beat it.
Start again.
Yeah, and I'd do that constantly. And then we had the N64, so my dad would get like Rogue Squadron, and thinking of the other one. Super Smash Brothers, of course. That's when
you played Smash 64?
Yeah.
Bullshit. I thought you said that you never you skipped that one, went straight to Melee. Mm-mm. I thought you told me. Was it you?
That's me. I've never. Yeah.
Okay. All right.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun.
I can kick your ass in 64
Smash. Yeah, I believe it. I haven't played them forever.
Yeah. Well, I mean, like, we did that one time when we played it. Yeah, and did. I did whoop ass, but.
You're like, no, I kicked your ass.
But I just.
Yeah, you're better than me at that.
Okay, yeah, that's one thing I'll keep.
That's one thing, yeah. Yes.
Clemente?
My first video game was Yoshi's Island on the Game Boy. And I just loved
Game
Yoshi.
Boy Advance?
Yeah, Game Boy. Okay, like, so, I had the purple.
Yeah.
Is that the Advance?
Yeah, it's the purple one.
And then my first, like, console was a GameCube. I never had a Nintendo 64. And I got Smash Melee so I could play my cousins. And then, yeah, I got really good at Melee.
Are the rumors true that you were not fed unless you got to beat, unless you beat them?
That's up to your own imagination. Whatever you want to believe. But yeah, those were my games.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Christian?
I started out with the Super Nintendo. I had Yoshi's Island. Okay. I had Mario Kart. I had Super Mario World. No, that was... Yeah, Super Mario World was on there. I had Donkey Kong Country. I had the classic games on the SNES, and then I had a Nintendo 64. Mario Party was my jam. Mm.
He keeps campaigning for a Mario Party.
Yes, I'm going to play it so bad. Cause
it's going to happen at some point.
Eventually, yeah.
I love Mario Party.
It's so fun. Mm-hmm. And then I had Donkey Kong 64, Mario Kart 64. I had Super Mario 64.
Damn.
That one. I had that was my favorite one.
Pretty much had all the good ones.
Yeah, I didn't have Super Smash Bros. So that's the only one I didn't play.
Missed out.
Yeah, and then I got an Xbox for Christmas. Halo was the game that I got with it, and Forza Motorsport was the one with that. Had a PS1, you know. I had them, and then I don't know what happened. I think I sold them because I was a kid, whatever. I sold them for like $2 or something like that.
At GameStop.
Or not, like, to my friend or something like that. And, you know, it was the worst decision of my life because I wish I still had them.
And then they're worth something.
Yeah, they're all worth the money. Yeah. Now I have a Wii U. My brother has an Xbox 360 that I play sometimes. We're going to try to get a PS4 or a Xbox One, but we don't know.
PS4.
PS4.
Yeah.
But the rumors of the Nintendo NX... are coming out, so that looks pretty cool. Mm-hmm. So we'll have to see. I don't know.
And my video game history is very simple. It's check out this Let's Play series. I think one of the third or fourth Let's Play I did was Super Mario World for the Super Nintendo, the very first game I remember playing ever.
Yeah, cool. It was it's my favorite game.
Yes, it's such a good game. I did a Twitch stream of Legend of Zelda: Link's Awakening for the Game Boy Color. It was it was a Christmas where I got the Game Boy, an original gray, like, super old school fat Game Boy with that and Tetris as the two games that I got for Christmas that year. And beat that game as a little kid and still beat it every so often, like, just to play it because it's comfort food.
Mm-hmm. A Link to the Past is the one I had for the
Super Nintendo.
Yeah, that one was fun.
Funny story about that one is that the PS4 had came out. Like, the launch day, like, I picked it up at launch day for the midnight launch release or whatever. Uh-huh. The very next day, I was not playing Call of Duty Ghosts for the PS4 because I got that in Knack. God damn, that game sucks. Anyways.
It's Knack, baby.
You know what it is?
Okay, yeah, okay. I know what you're talking about.
All right. So, the PS4, got that. And so instead of playing Call of Duty, like, with the graphics and, oh, shit, this badass explosions and stuff like that, I was playing A Link to the Past on the Super Nintendo.
That's my favorite. That's
pretty cool. Well, you didn't miss much with Ghost. Ghost sucked.
Oh, yeah. I know, Ghost did suck. I did beat that game. I did beat the campaign in it. Me too. Sucked. But I actually kind of liked it. But it was my first Call of Duty game. You didn't Nintendo. Mm-hmm.
Your first
one. The reason why I was playing the Super Nintendo A Link to the Past was because A Link Between Worlds is coming out 2 weeks or 3 weeks later.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
So I needed to beat the game
before
playing the sequel. And mm-hmm. I'm glad I did because it made playing the sequel easier because I knew all the secrets were.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Cool. Mm,
yes. And then, okay, that's a good, that's a nice little rapid fire round. Next. What do y'all do? All of y'all. Go for it.
I am a student at Texas State, and I am an illustrator for the school paper.
Nice.
Yeah.
You draw?
Yeah.
Do you draw like on a? Do you draw like on those like pads that's got the stylus and you like and it shows up on your screen whatever you're drawing?
Yeah.
Nice. What is it? Adobe something?
No, it's like a Wacom board. It's like, and it's like its own thing, and it came with its own program. And it's really crappy, but I thought it was gonna be
like super like.
No, it's nothing really special at all.
It's Texas State.
I figured if it's university property equipment,
it's mine that I bought like before I even interviewed for the job and stuff. I got it because I was an art student in high school, and so I wanted to try digital art, and then I had it, so I thought I could get a job with it, and I did.
Nice. That's what's up.
Well, I am a Texas State alumni.
I've
not graduated. Get out of here.
Alumni.
Those are for graduates.
I've been on spring break since January.
Spring break.
Spring.
Forever.
No, I'm a beauty school dropout, and I
Wait, really?
No, I was Texas State. No.
I mean, I don't know if they
I'm
had
a dropout, school. But not
if
beauty
they had
school
a, if they had a program, no, like, no, no, I was no, like, no. Oh shit, that'd be nice.
No.
Let's backtrack. All right, was it because you had bad grades that first semester, or because you didn't sign re-enroll?
I got mono and strep throat.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
All right. Well, so you didn't re-enroll.
Yeah, I was being yeah. And I now lifeguard, and I'll be going to school in Austin in the fall.
Austin, damn. Mm-hmm. So you're wait,
not UT. I'm not that smart.
UT,
yeah.
I was gonna say UT.
I wish.
Austin.
No. St. Edward's.
Okay, that's what's up. Mm-hmm. Lifeguard. So are you gonna be lifeguarding throughout the summer, during peak season?
Yes, I think so. Mm-hmm. So I'll have less time to play, and y'all can win. So.
Okay. So you better make sure you get June 18th off.
Yeah, I mean, I already like have it on my calendar and stuff. Okay. So,
all right. Have you actually, as a lifeguard, have you actually had to do anything exciting? Like, have to like jump from your board, your sitting thing?
I wouldn't
you
know what to do. On, like, I would have been like, I would have called someone to come help them because I don't know what.
You're not gonna go in your CPR.
I'm gonna call whoever.
It's like, you're the person that they call, and yet you're going to be like, I'm going to call someone else.
No, I know what to do. It's just, it hasn't happened to me yet, thank goodness.
All right, is your job, knock on glass.
Oh my gosh, is that what?
You got the back of your, yeah, there you go.
There we go.
Are you glad that it hasn't happened because people are safe or because you
don't want
to have
do
it?
The people are safe.
Oh,
or
yeah.
Maybe, I just
yeah,
don't know what's
sure,
I'm not. I'm like on my phone on stand. Like, I don't.
This, well, since when was this podcast Miss America is what I want to know. Giving the fucking world peace answer. Fuck that.
World peace.
You know you are doing that.
Oh, my gosh. I mean, I'm saving lives. I don't know what y'all are doing. So.
Is saving lives like, hey, kid, stop running? Like,
that's basically
whistle,
it, yeah.
Whistle, stop running.
So you whistle out little children walking.
It's mostly old people.
Oh, okay.
It's like old people.
Don't run.
Like, you break your back.
Yeah.
So you do whistle, obviously, right? Like,
yeah.
Whistle, and then, shit, I didn't even lose my train of thought. Fuck, I was going to ask you some stupid question. It was going to be a joke in there. Fuck.
We'll come back later. Yeah.
I was going to say, do you ever, like, one time this was like when I was like 13 years old or whatever, I was at a swimming place or whatever, and so like the lifeguard was like whistled at me and he put me on timeout. Can you actually do that or no?
I can, but I usually get like the head guard to do it. Like, there was one time these kids were like running and like jumping head first into like 3 feet of water.
What the fuck?
Yeah, and I was like, somebody's gonna die. I was like, we can like double whistle to call someone, and I was like, hey, like, they're jumping in head first and like they're gonna get a concussion. And she talked to their parents and they grounded them and they didn't come back for like 2 weeks.
Oh my God.
I felt so bad. I was like, I wasn't the one who said it. So
snitches get
and end up in ditches. Yeah,
God damn. All right, Christian, top that.
I don't think I can, but
I talked for a long time. I'm sorry.
No, that's okay.
No, I'm asking follow-up questions. Everybody got follow-up questions because I'm thinking them up on the fly.
I go to Tarrant County College right now.
South or central?
Trinity River.
No,
it's the one downtown.
Trinity River is
yeah.
what I meant.
What is it?
It looks like that's the only community college that I know of that looks like a university.
Yeah, it feels like a university too. Yeah.
It's nice.
Yeah.
It's super nice.
50
Cent was there.
Really?
What? Yes. He killed 50 Cent with
yes, he literally was there. I saw like some Facebook posts where he was walking by with an entourage, and it was what? Like, and then it was Trinity River. I swear to God, it was.
That's crazy.
And then they were like, I saw a quick shot of him walking.
50
and,
Cent getting 50 his cent. Degree.
I think he was there because about time. No. See, the thing is, he's a promoter, and okay. Next to the same building that Trinity River shares with Radio Shack.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And so I think he had something to do with Radio Shack there.
Like some product or something.
Yeah, project. Yeah. So that's why.
Yeah. I saw Bill Clinton there. Like
what?
Yeah. I went to like he spoke at Trinity River. For Hillary, for the campaign, and
oh,
I
really,
I attended the thing. I skipped class and I attended it.
Damn, that's what's up.
Yeah, cool. It was fun. But
does it make you want to be a part of the political stuff? No, okay. Does it inspire you to
okay, run for office?
No, yeah,
not run for office, but like be more like attuned to like you know.
No, I mean I know what's going on, but no. but yeah.
Yeah, but no.
I'm a science major. Hopefully. Neuroscience. What else do? I'm a loser.
Mm, yes, as we all are.
Yeah.
I serve at Blue Sushi Sake Grill downtown, West 7th. Mm, mm. It's pretty good. I like it. I've almost been there a month. I mean, not a month. A year. I've almost been there a year. That's, I've been promoted
that's
twice.
A big thing. And that's a big difference.
Yeah.
From what to what?
From busser to barback to server. And probably gonna be a manager pretty soon.
Hmm. Sick. The first time I heard it, like I had to replay it in my mind, but it sounded like you said you were a buster.
I'm a buster.
You're a buster. Ain't no. Yeah. You still a buster.
Still a buster. No, but yeah, I play video games like we all do. Hmm. What do I do? What else do I do?
That sounds pretty accurate.
Yeah.
And you're an aspiring filmmaker. No, I'm just kidding. Picture on screen.
We've done one thing,
and that has not aired yet.
Yeah. I have a dog, a Boston Terrier. He's my life.
If you text me a picture, I'll put it on.
Yeah, screen. I'll send a picture.
it's on screen somewhere.
Also, a picture of my dog.
No one cares about your dog.
If you text it to me,
my dog would kick your dog's ass.
My dog will go Michael Vick on your dog.
Yeah.
God damn.
Yeah. His name's Jack. He's 5 months old. He's crazy. But yeah, that's pretty much me.
What is your stance on neutering? Yes, neutering.
I don't do that. Okay. So I let my dogs have their.
Have
their junk.
We were on our way to pick up Israel, and there's like a show of two dogs. Like,
oh yeah,
like these two dogs are standing on the fence, and they were getting it on.
Yeah. Oh
like,
my god!
It was like, and the it was dog,
like a little
the
chihuahua,
dog was like a little chihuahua, and then this like
lab.
Oh yeah. It was like, yeah, there were a bunch of stray dogs in my neighborhood.
Oh yeah. My god,
it's crazy.
They're getting it on.
Yeah.
Other than that, your typical Mexican American kid.
All right.
So, but yeah.
All right. Final question for this topic: what are your dreams and aspirations?
Wow.
Me? Who are you?
Usually we've been doing Israel Clemente Christian. Is how we've been doing.
My
if
dreams.
You wanna, if you guys have something, I can jump in. If you want to give to Israel some time.
I want to be a neurosurgeon. I want to save lives. Hopefully, want to cure some sort of major brain disorder. Disability, whatever, you know.
Either A, cure Alzheimer's or / dementia, or B, maybe cure some, what do you call it, when people shake and stuff like that?
Yeah, Parkinson's disease. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, I want to get an MD and then go get a PhD, so.
God damn, that's going to be a lot of
school. It's going to be forever. I'm going to be an old man by the time I get out, but it'll be worth it.
I
think.
It will.
All right, so then that means you're going to go to university after your 2 years is done.
Mm-hmm.
So what do you know what school you're thinking about?
Probably Trinity. I was thinking about TCU, but TCU's hell of expensive. So
Texas State is the cheapest.
Yeah, but it doesn't
college.
Have what I want.
Go to UT that's almost.
True. Yeah.
UTA.
Yes.
UTA.
Yeah. No.
In Arlington, almost. Not Austin.
Yeah.
That's what. That's what one of my teachers at the TCC referred to it as UT almost.
UT almost.
That's messed up.
Oh
which is where I go to now, but you know, whatever.
That's cool.
Yeah. I mean, yeah. Wherever you can get an education, I guess. But yeah. Trinity, because they have a neuroscience program as well, and it's cheaper than TCU. So.
Okay.
And then TCU and UNT are supposed to like combine to make a medical school around here sometime.
Really?
Yeah, in the next couple of years. So if that happens, I'll probably go there.
Yeah.
Nice.
That's cool.
Yeah.
Clemente.
Me? I guess no matter what I do, like, just to be happy, like, cheesy. You
know? What did I tell you about Miss America pageants? What did I tell you?
This is an interview. This
instead of the champion, it's Miss America.
Miss America Clemente.
Miss Texas.
Miss Texas Clemente.
Goodness.
De la Cruz.
Yeah. But I'm looking more into the medical field too, but not
feral. Make sure if you're gonna mutter a lot, please mutter into the mic.
Yeah, you're right.
Because like this is ideally like the good spot because
okay.
If you're gonna when you watch the podcast, because you know you will, you're not gonna hear yourself very clearly.
Okay.
Yeah.
But yeah, I couldn't do all that schooling, so probably like nursing or something like that.
Nursing.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Oh wait, like meet the parents.
No. Like nursing.
Meet the parents. Greg,
I guess so.
Greg Fokker. He was a male nurse, and everybody made fun of him for it. But again, that was also it was a different time. It was 2003 when that movie came out.
It's 2016 now. Anybody can be anything they want.
Exactly. Yeah. He paved the way. Ben Stiller's character paved the way for you.
Thank you, Ben Stiller.
Ben Stiller is your hero. He's my hero.
Israel.
All right.
All this time to think.
Yeah, so I want to become an art teacher and hopefully one at Pass School because they have a good art program. Hmm. And I don't know, I'd just be there kind of just guiding the children and their imagination because, man, school sucks nowadays with all these standardized testing, being taught how to think and whatnot. It's horrible. It's poor children.
I agree. Yeah. I hate grades. I hate everything about them.
I don't necessarily hate grades. I hate homework more than anything.
Yeah.
If we don't have to take any of that home, that work home, and that's basically where it's at. If we can accomplish everything in the building in school, then I don't care about grades.
I also want to live forever, and I want to have a big house with a big yard, so I can have a lot of dogs and cats
and a trophy wife
and a really hot wife.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
And maybe like some pigs too. Some other animals.
And a sports car.
Mexican. A good car. No, I'll have a hybrid. Oh. I'll be driving a hybrid.
Get the fuck out of here.
There will be solar panels on top of my house.
This podcast does not tolerate SJWs. Social justice warriors for the non-informed.
Oh my god.
I think they're cool looking. They're even making them to kind of. They're trying to sell them to as
like
kind of like
new,
sport cars now.
Yeah,
I like
the new Prius. It actually looks pretty decent.
Prius, yeah.
Yeah.
Priuses look kind of
They're
cool.
starting to, yeah, they're starting to, like, design them to look, like, oh, to appeal to the young single man or whatever.
Also, like, I mean, there's nothing cooler than good gas mileage, right?
Yeah.
There's nothing cooler than saving the world.
Yeah, that too. I want to be a superhero, buddy.
You know what?
Saving gas.
There's like I say, don't go all South Park and be all smug and make a smug cloud.
Oh, my gosh.
And then whenever the George Clooney smugness from the thing.
Good for you.
Thank you for knowing the reference. All right. Let's move on to the next topic. Christian, do you want to go next?
Sure.
Go for it.
My topic is, since now we have a couple of games that have been remastered, such as Twilight Princess, you know, in HD, you know, some of the Pokemons that have been
Final
remade.
Fantasy.
Omega Ruby, yeah. Sapphire, all that stuff.
Leaf Green.
Stuff. Okay, so.
Go on with Pokemon.
Yeah, just all of them.
All the Pokemons have been remade, yes.
But which game, if any, would you like to see remade or remastered? So if anybody wants to go
simple
first.
Answer would be the Mega Man series, Mega Man's 2 through 10, like their Super 8-bit. But imagine like I was trying to imagine that game as like an open world like kind of thing where you're just going to fighting robot masters and stuff, kind of like Legend of Zelda-esque, I guess.
Yeah, okay,
that's cool.
Like a third person action adventure.
Mm-hmm. I can see that.
Cool. Yeah.
Honestly, that would be pretty cool.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
I guess one that I would say is like not like a remaster, but like. Did y'all ever play the Dragon Ball Z Budokai Tenkaichi games?
Yes.
Yeah.
They have not. Like, the last one was the last one was the third one for the PlayStation 2, right?
Oh, man.
That was, like, the best game ever that I've ever played. They were so much fun. And, like, I wish they'd, like, make a fourth one or, like, an HD version of the third one.
I liked the regular Budokai, like...
What, the 2D one?
Yeah.
Yeah, that one's cool, too.
Those were my favorite.
Oh, they're, like... Street Fighter,
like,
kind of
yeah.
Yeah,
that one was cool too.
I didn't like the Tenkaichi that much.
You didn't?
No. Because I liked Budokai was all about like button inputs.
Yeah, and this one you just push one button and you'll be able to do
it. I didn't like it.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah.
So I've been looking at my list because I have an inventory of every video game that I have in my house.
Really?
Yes. And so most of these games I'm looking through because I have them sort from oldest to newest. And these games, majority of these games have been remastered in some way.
Yeah.
Like I'm looking at like Nintendo 64, you got your Ocarina of Time and Majora's Mask.
Mm-hmm.
Pretty much Mario Karts don't count because in Mario Party, because they get sequels that are basically the same thing.
Yeah.
Resident Evil got remastered and it's getting remastered again. Pokemon's Gold and Silver got remastered and all that stuff. Basically, pretty much anything you can think of has come out again.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Which is crazy when I think about it. But I would like an Earthbound sequel. Fuck you, I mean.
Earthbound?
Yes.
I've never played Earthbound.
It's fun.
It's legit. Yeah.
I've never played Earthbound before.
It's pretty cool. I like it.
Hmm. See. So I'm looking at here. Something very obscure I found. Brave Fencer Musashi. It's an RPG. JRPG. It's super niche. Yeah. You guys probably never heard of it.
No.
I've never
exactly.
heard of it.
Yeah. Yes. I can dig that one. I can say that one probably needs a remaster.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But it's owned by Square and they're full of shit. they are.
Speaking of RPGs, my one would be Super Mario RPG, The Legend of Seven Stars.
Oh my
that
god.
That game is it's for the Super NES.
Yes. Yes.
And it's so like fun. Like you get to play as Mario,
Bowser,
Peach, Geno, there's Mallow, there's different characters like characters and
mm-hmm.
I played it when I was a kid. I didn't mention that one, but I had it when I was a kid. I played it. I didn't get past like the first like boss or whatever because I was a stupid kid and I didn't know how to do anything. But I played it again on emulator and stuff like that. I love it. It's great. I wish they would remake it or make a sequel to it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's the problem with that is that they're Geno and some other character in the game is owned by Square.
Yeah.
Square Enix, and mm-hmm. so the collaboration between the two of them. I mean, it's good enough that we got Cloud in Smash. Yeah. So.
I mean, they made a Geno Mii costume.
Yeah.
For Smash, so maybe. I don't know. Mm-hmm. Maybe Nintendo, please.
Cool. Give me a remake of F-Zero GX.
Nintendo. F-Zero? Yes. I love the soundtrack. Yes.
Mm-hmm. And also, a remake of Eternal Darkness for the GameCube.
I need that. Eternal Darkness.
I've never heard of that
one. Sanity's Requiem. Okay. It's a game where it's like a horror game, kind of like Resident Evil-ish, but not.
Mm-hmm.
And you're playing as this girl, and there's a sanity meter in there. So the more it goes up, the more insane you get, and the more it starts to fuck with you. So like for instance, because you're playing on a TV or whatever, like the TV would turn off, but it's still on, it's still running. It just goes black because it's simulating as if you turn off the TV.
Yeah.
It even like pretends that your save got deleted. Like, cause you're going insane, so it starts fucking
that's
with you.
That's crazy. That's cool.
It starts fucking with you in every which way, and it's a horror game. That's I don't know if it's owned by Nintendo, but I know it's like a second party made mm-hmm. it, and I don't know if Nintendo kept the copyright or the license or not, if they renewed it or not. But either give me a sequel or HD remake of that.
I really liked Rogue Squadron. I know they made one for GameCube, I think, right? But
I think even as far as N64 as well, maybe. But I
yeah, I think
Rogue Squadron.
So.
Yeah, and then they got Rogue Squadron 2 on GameCube.
Yeah,
and
I've been playing Battlefront, and like playing the mode with just the ships is like my favorite. But the way Rogue Squadron was like, you would have to like protect a convoy and like destroy the bombers and stuff. Mm-hmm. I don't know. That's like the only level I could play because I cannot pass Rogue Squadron on N64. It's so hard. Okay. I don't know. I just can't beat it. I tried playing it.
Mm-hmm. I want to give a shout out to Crash Bandicoot.
Oh, man.
Oh, yeah. I was just thinking about PlayStation 1 games.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was a good game. I loved it.
Crash Bandicoot.
There was a racing one, too, they had?
Crash Team Racing?
Mm-hmm.
Fuck you.
Oh, my gosh.
Wow. That escalated quickly.
I'll see you guys later. Right. See you. Yeah.
Clemente, anything else?
If they do make another Mario Kart, they should like give an option to do like the double dash
thing. Oh, yes.
I thought that was really
cool. That
one
was fun.
You talking about that Crash slash racing game, if you think of it. But that was so much fun. And, like, you could do two-player on it, where, like, the person in the back could control
the weapon.
That was so cool. Me and my brothers would play that all the time. It was so much fun.
Yeah. Basically, like, the little brother mode.
Yeah. You can do that. You can
throw stuff. You can handle the weapons. I got this. But, like, the best part about Double Dash is when you guys accomplish the Double Dash, when y'all both press the A button together.
Yes.
But you know what I did? Is, like, I always fucking cheated. It was, like, I just took the controller from my nieces or nephew, and I would basically like do like that. And just, so it's like, and I got it back. I got it back to him.
Oh my god,
that's funny.
Just so I can get the Double Dash in.
That's funny.
Yeah, but it's such a fucking like it's a sight to behold when you see it, because it's like blue thunder and lightning. Yeah, like, yeah. Boosh.
It's so much fun.
It's like super awesome. Yes, awesome. And it's so exaggerated because they're like hanging off the
yeah, they're like, about to fall off.
They're about to fall off. Like their feet are scraping the pavement.
Yeah, dude. Yeah.
That's the only one I haven't played. The only Mario Kart.
What the?
Yeah, I haven't played Double Dash.
That's
the best, man. I don't know. I mean, for me, I think Mario Kart 8 might be the best one, just because of how it controls.
It has more stages. But
the stages, but DLC. Yeah. I guess the DLC really did it for me. But like, it just control. I played GameCube, and I was like, it doesn't control as smoothly and precisely as I like, because they basically fine tune the mechanics so your drift is good. Because, you know, back in the day, like, you had a drift. When you drift, you had to, like, press the analog stick left, right, left, right, left, right. Whereas in the new games, you just kind of turn into it and it drifts.
I like the 3DS version, too. It's still pretty good.
Yes.
That one's fun to play a lot.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I like that over the DS version, because you can download and play the whole entire game.
Yeah.
Whereas, it's like, in the DS, they only limit you to 8 stages, which is fucked up.
Yeah. Yeah. Also remake Monkey Ball.
I love Monkey Ball.
Monkey Ball. Yes. My first exposure to that game was through an emulator I was in 8th grade. Mm-hmm. And there was a Game Boy Advance emulator in the computer to our science class, and it had Monkey Ball in there, or Super Monkey Ball. Yeah.
That's cool.
And we used to play golf on that, because there's like one like that golf.
Oh, you hit it,
You hit it, and then he rolls and stuff like that. Yeah, those are the days. I wish I could play that game again. Mm-hmm. I don't know what game it was in the series, because there's a whole bunch of them.
Yeah, mm-hmm.
Spyro. I like that one.
Fuck Spyro. Skylanders.
The PlayStation
Skylanders.
Fuck Skylanders.
Because I have Skylanders.
I like Spyro. Oh, I like it just fine.
Yeah,
but they desecrated that fucking IP out, and they made Skylanders. Mm-hmm. And you know, when the game first came out, they used to market it as Spyro and the Skylanders. And now it's just Skylanders. Yes. All right.
Rip, skip, Spyro.
Anybody else? Like Spyro. Final word?
Nope.
All right. That's a pretty good one.
Yeah. A good one. All right. Clemente, what's your topic?
Well, did we talk about like how we knew each other yet?
No.
We didn't.
And I did not come up in my interview, you guys. But yes, let's go for it.
Okay. I thought you said, like, how, like, we knew, like, the history behind us or whatever.
Yeah, I asked 3 questions.
Okay, well, then we're
not going to go to a live story.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, my bad.
I mean, I kind of sort of did.
Yeah, yeah.
We kind of sort of did. But
and there it was.
It's like, and there I was.
Okay. What was your topic?
Oh, characters that were never in Super Smash that we would want in Super Smash.
Okay. Solid Snake.
And like they could be Nintendo, not Nintendo, anything like that.
So basically, there's no limit. Like we can basically put Goku.
Goku. Yeah, definitely. No, like Batman. I think my top 3 would be like Goku, Naruto, and Sora. I think those would be really cool characters in the game.
I would like to see, was it DK Rool or something?
King K. Rool.
Yeah, from that. Donkey Kong?
The crocodile? Like,
yeah.
Donkey Kong Country, yeah. The boss villain.
Yeah, that's cool.
He's pretty cool. Goku, because why not?
Because why not, right? I really only had 3 in my mind, where it's like, anyone else that I mentioned that's outside of these 3 are just pie in the sky, that whatever, just throw them in there.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, throw in Optimus Prime, or like this fire truck, and I'm scared.
Oh my gosh.
You know which video I'm talking about.
The donkey
about,
video?
Right? Yeah, that's the video I'm talking about.
A fire truck?
It's like, what was it, a Samus or a Seamus?
Yeah, that's one of his, like.
Oh, that's another one?
Yeah, that's a different one, but like, there's one of them, it's like, we're gonna get the rock's head. put it on Muffin Man's body, and Muffin Man's gonna be riding a Shamu, and Shamu's gonna open his mouth, and then Iron Man comes out, and Iron Man says, "Who ordered the fish and chips?"
King Needy. Uh-huh. Yeah, all right, that was a tangent. Oh, I was gonna say I only have really three picks that I only care about, and everyone else is gonna be like that. Yeah. Or I just do that.
Yeah.
But number one, obviously Solid Snake. Number two, Ice Climbers. Mm. Number three, which is above and all, the one I voted for at the Smash ballot. Mm-hmm. I voted for Shovel Knight, and I really, really would have loved if Shovel Knight was in Smash.
Yeah, cool. Shovel Knight's a like indie game one, right?
Yeah, indie game. Played it. Beat the game. Love the game. Really? His move set would have just come right off the game, like just perfect. A lot of those aerials and everything. Yeah. And I just think that was a good one. He already had palette swaps already ready to go because he could just pull it from the game. Mm-hmm. I think that was a good pick.
Mm-hmm. Mine, Batman.
Batman.
Batman would be cool.
Did you wearing a Batman shirt right now?
He does not belong in Smash.
Batman would be cool.
This is not Marvel versus Capcom. This is not Injustice. Yeah.
His neutral special would be like a batarang, and then like I don't know. He could I guess he would be kind of like salt, like a Solid Snake, but with like less.
Yeah. Why didn't guns? They put Snake back know. In the game?
Huh?
I thought a lot of people liked Snake.
I did. Yeah. I said
why didn't he go back in the why
was because he belongs to Konami.
Yeah.
He's not a Nintendo character.
Oh, I see. Yeah.
So Konami's also on their rag, so you know.
Oh, I see. Okay.
So Batman is my first one. The second what one.
Can you imagine a Final Smash for Batman?
Yeah.
What would happen?
The same one isn't.
It's just like the Captain Batmobile. Falcons, but it's a Batmobile.
The Batmobile. Yeah.
Oh, nice. Wait, Captain Falcons, but with the Batmobile?
Yeah, it's the exact same. Batmobile.
Batman. Come on.
And, like,
and then he calls the Batmobile and he hits him off and he goes into Gotham City all of a sudden. Yeah. And then like all of Mario in his fucking bright colors is in like fucking dark Gotham City. And like looking like he's about to get shanked, and then he's kind of rolling with the tumbler. Yes. I like that Let's one.
See. My second one would be. Well, you already said Goku. Piccolo.
Piccolo.
Krillin. Krillin. Yamcha.
Tien.
Tien. Chiaotzu.
I pick Chi Chi.
But Nintendo character for my third one, Waluigi.
Waluigi. Ooh. What is it with people who want Waluigi? Like, I don't understand. Because I know you're talking. I've heard other people talk about it and stuff.
He's just cool. Like, he's a cool villain.
Yeah.
With the tennis racket. With the
tennis racket. It'd be so funny. I just love to hear it.
I would like how Waluigi is both, he's an assist trophy in the game. He's an assist trophy and a playable character.
Waluigi gets a Waluigi.
Oh my gosh.
Clemente.
I already said my three.
You did?
Mm-hmm.
Fuck.
Mm-hmm.
Christian.
I already said my
fuck.
Yeah,
was that really that quick?
Yeah, it was that quick.
God damn it. All right. Well, we should kill time.
Okay.
Kill time.
No, okay, never mind.
Well, did you talk about your topic?
Yeah.
Yeah, we did.
With the one
that I did. And then
Israel's topic is next.
My topic is about games that come from movies.
Oh, that's right.
Or games that turn into movies.
Okay.
What are your opinions on them?
All right. So I saw a YouTube video about a subject as why video game movies suck and will always suck or something like that. It made a point. Basically, the point is that because you are interacting with, because you're the one playing the game, like, that's the reason why it will never be when you're what it holds. The movie will never be that because it's a different experience. It's a passive experience, and you'll never be able to get that interaction, and that's why they're really not good for that.
Okay.
Hopefully, Last of Us movie / maybe Assassin's Creed.
Last of Us.
I think they are making an Assassin's Creed movie.
No, December, right?
It's coming out this year.
Yeah. Okay, see.
No, I was talking about the... I'm not really big on the Assassin's Creed franchise, so I was just saying, like, there's a chance that Assassin's Creed might be the first video game movie that's actually good.
Yeah.
But, I mean, is there really movies that turn into games? Yes, there is.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, a lot.
There's been, like...
The Worst Offender.
Yeah, Scarface. There's been a Scarface game after the movies came out. It's called Scarface, like, The World is Ours or Yours, something like that. And you get to play as Tony Montana, like, doing... like. selling coke and killing people.
Bullshit. Yeah. On what?
On the Xbox. And I think it's on PlayStation 2. Okay. Like the original Xbox and PS2. Hmm. I enjoyed it. Because, I watched the movie, I enjoyed the movie. And then I played the game, and I really enjoyed the game. It's kind of like a Grand Theft Auto-esque kind of thing.
No, The Godfather. They even did that to The Godfather.
Yeah, they did. Mm-hmm. I haven't played The Godfather 1 on PSP before. It was really cool. You could, go in there and, fuck with people, shoot them, do whatever. It's cool.
It's cool.
Is anyone planning on watching Warcraft?
Yeah.
Maybe. I mean, I don't
I do. I don't know if it's going to be good or not. The graphics are kind of pretty, cool.
I was going to say pretty,
I don't know.
Not lousy. I would say they are good. Yeah. The thing about it is, I've seen a lot of behind-the-scenes documentaries, featurettes, interviews. And they were talking about how this is going to push the boundaries of CGI and how photorealistic it was. Really? And when I saw the trailer, I was not impressed with the look. I was like, oh,
yeah.
I was thinking that it was going to be even more realistic looking, but this looks totally CG.
Yeah. Yeah. It looks, just the same quality as Avatar.
Yeah. Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
And it's just I've seen Avatar.
This isn't pushing the boundaries of graphic fidelity.
Yeah.
It's pretty much keeping the balance of what it already is.
That's basically why people went to see Avatar, right? Because it looked so awesome. Because
it looked cool. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, but this isn't 2009 anymore.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. It should be way more better than what it was.
And then when you were talking about CGI, I watched The Matrix Reloaded recently, and the CGI was terrible. I thought it looked so photorealistic, and it was and then you could tell his face was so super bad. Composited and everything. And
Have you played the Matrix games?
No, I haven't. Is it Enter the Matrix or something like that? Yeah. No, I haven't played it.
I played them a little bit. And I was young, so it was hard, of course, but it still looks pretty cool. I mean, you fly around kind of. Not fly around, but you flip around and shoot at the same time. I don't know, stuff you see in the movie.
Yeah.
Matrix is a freaking awesome movie.
Yes.
I've never seen the Matrix.
Clemente. Matrix.
There's the door.
Yeah, there it is.
Come back when you see the Matrix.
All right, so there's the biggest offender that you when you're talking about this topic. I thought of an example, which is the most atrocious example, which is super meta. It was a video game that was turned into a movie that was turned into a game.
What?
So they made the movie out of a game, and then they made the game
out of the movie.
Of that movie?
Yeah.
That's
that's
and
weird.
It sucked.
Yeah,
it
did, sounds like it did.
Street Fighter 2.
Oh, the freaking Secret of Chun Li or whatever.
No,
movie?
No. Oh, okay,
the one with Rod Van Damme.
With Jean Claude Van Damme.
Oh
yes.
My God,
there was So there was Street Fighter 2, the game Super Nintendo and arcade and stuff like that. Uh-huh. Hit the world by storm. They made a movie with Jean Claude Van Damme as Guile, and the guy from Adam's Family is him Bison, They made the movie, and I guess it was an okay financial success. Mm-hmm. It sucked, but people got the ticket sales before people let on. This is before the internet age where you can just tweet that this movie sucks and don't watch it, So then they made a video game for the PlayStation 1 where it was the actual Jean-Claude Van Damme, and they digitized sprites like Mortal Kombat. Mm-hmm. You know, Mortal Kombat 1 was a digitized sprite.
Yeah.
They did that and converted the actors into the characters of Street Fighter and made them do Hadoukens and Hurricane Kicks and stuff like that. But it was super bad graphics and super clunky and did not work. And it was this terrible meta example of what you're talking about where they turned a game into a movie into a game again.
Oh my Jesus.
Did you ever watch Mortal Kombat with Joey and I?
One?
Maybe it was the first one.
Mortal Kombat 1. Great movie.
That was a good movie. Second one, actually. Sucks.
Was it Armageddon or something like that?
Annihilation.
Yeah, that one.
Mm-hmm.
That one was
terrible.
Yeah. Those were fun to watch.
And then I want to give a shout out to Sly Cooper coming out in April.
Oh my God.
Is there a movie coming out?
The movie's coming out. Okay, so they got the game, right?
Yeah.
And they're making a movie, and they're making a game out of the movie.
They're doing the same thing?
They're doing the same thing.
Oh, dang.
Except the game actually looks good.
Sly Cooper's good. Did you play the PlayStation 3 one?
No.
The Thieves in Time or whatever?
Yeah.
You played that one?
The first one was my favorite.
Yes.
I don't know why. But
The reason why I bring that up is because they're rebooting it, I guess, because the game that's coming out is Sly Cooper 1, but remastered. But it's not a remaster. It's not a remake. It's kind of it's got the levels, but it's not I don't know.
Mechanics?
It's same mechanics. It's basically a remake without calling it a remake. I don't know what they're calling it. But basically, they're making the movie based off of that, and so they're kind of like off working off of each other.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know, but I don't know. I have hope for the movie and the game.
Yeah, because the game that'd was, be cool, was fun. Yeah, so I'd watch the movie.
Mm-hmm. And too. I want to give a shout out to Spider-Man 2, the game.
Spider-Man 2, the game was the best.
That is the best for the PS2.
Yes.
Oh my god, it was the best.
Fun.
Okay.
Well, I had it for Xbox, but it was fun.
I think I played the first Spider-Man game on GameCube.
On GameCube, is that the one where you could like you just held R and like you would swing around the city?
I think so.
Yeah, is that one. I love that one.
Yeah, it was ported to the Xbox GameCube. And
Mm-hmm. Like so if you fell on the ground, you'd die or something like that.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Okay, I want to. The reason why I bring that one up is because that game is probably the best Spider-Man game ever. It is like it the swinging mechanics were the best because you get to swing around the city and everything like that. And then, like, whenever you got your upgrades, and you upgrade, and you can do two webs, and you can pull, and then launch yourself, slingshot. Like, in the movie, and slingshot, that was, like, the truth right there.
That was fun.
that was fun.
Have you played the, there was, like, a Spider-Man, I don't know if it was N64, or if it was on, I think I played it on the computer. It was, like, a really good Spider-Man game. I don't know what it was called.
My God. And this was on the PC?
Yeah, I played it on my, like, Windows 97 computer.
Okay.
And it was like really fun and really good, and like I would you would go through like all the main villains like Scorpion and all of them. It was a long time ago. I'm just thinking of I played a long time ago.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Oh, I mean, I've never played a Spider-Man game on a computer before.
Mm-hmm.
Like everything, it's always been on a handheld or on a.
I need to find out what that game is. Mm-hmm. I need to.
That'd be fun.
If you do, text me. Yeah. I'll put something on the screen where it's like, it was this. Like, editor's note.
It'll be like a picture of it or something. Yeah. Okay. I'll find it. Yeah.
All right. And so let's see here. I feel like there's others that I want to say that come to mind. I want to just give a shout out to general, like, whenever movies are come out as games at the same time. Like, one of my favorite games was for the PlayStation 1. And this game, by the way, it might suck. I haven't played it in a long time. But I did beat the game multiple times to the point where I had to buy the game again because the discs were so worn out, like scratches and like, not scratches,
from
but
rotating.
Like, from rotating all the time. So like the disc was unreadable. Dang. And I had to buy the disc again just to play it some more. And part of the reason why, just as an FYI, as a side story, part of the reason why it was so unreadable is because I had to start the game over all over again because I didn't have a PS1 memory card.
Oh, dang.
So I couldn't save anything. Oh. So every time I turn it off, I have to start it back up from the beginning. And by the time I'd been done with that game, I was a fucking pro at that game. And I know every secret. I knew every shortcut. I knew where all the drops were. Oh, my God. Mm-hmm. It was Star Wars Episode 1, The Phantom Menace, the game.
Dang.
The game, yes. Mm. And then it was cool because the PS1, it's got like they had like bonus features where they had the music video,
uh-huh.
and they had like the FMV videos, like full motion videos, where they had like it was kind of like a DVD where they had like the actual footage of like behind the scenes, kind of like actual footage of the Star Wars movie.
Shout out to games that used to do that. Now they don't do any of that.
Like what? Like,
like just, there was a game that I had for the Xbox. 50 Cent, Get Rich or Die Trying.
After
you beat the game, like throughout the game, you would get unlockables and stuff like that. You get the music, you get like videos and like that. You can go back and like you could watch the music videos of like the characters, like 50 Cent, was it Young Buck and everybody,
really?
Everybody in
G Unit.
Yeah, everybody in G Unit. Like you'd be able to like you could play as them. So you'd go back and like watch the music videos of whatever song they were in, like get to listen to the soundtrack, and it was like that was a pretty legit game. What else? Like, yeah, just games like that, you know.
I was gonna say just give a shout out to that whole genre because it doesn't exist anymore.
Yeah,
licensed games that come out with the movies, like I can't remember the last time that's happened. Maybe like I want to say like X-Men Wolverine game came out with the Wolverine movie.
I think there's some. Like movies that shouldn't be turned into games, and like one that comes off like I'm thinking of Where the Wild Things Are.
That was a game.
That was a game. And I saw it at GameStop.
What
and I
for?
Was
what
like,
the DS?
No, for it was maybe Xbox 360 or
what
PlayStation 3.
Fuck
yeah!
That sounds like a bad idea.
I saw it and I was just like, "What the hell? What are you thinking?" I don't know.
What would you even do?
But I feel like a lot of, like, I don't know, like, kids movies gets turned into games, I think.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Just to get more money out of it.
Yeah, cash out.
Yeah.
Did y'all ever play the Harry Potter games?
I have not.
Those are actually really fun.
I played Harry Potter, the Sorcerer's Stone, like the one, like on
the GameCube?
On the Game Boy. Yeah. That one was fun. I like
actually,
that
no, wait, I take that back. It was on the GameCube.
That was like Pokemon. You had to like, spell or whatever like that. Yeah.
It was fun.
As the years went on, it went on to different systems because I remember seeing that. I remember seeing the actual year one on the PlayStation 1. By the time you got to year three, it was on the PS2.
Oh, yeah.
And then by the time you got to year seven, it was on the PS3. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. So, like, it was jumping generations as it came out.
That's a long movie series.
That movie series lasts like a decade. So, it was like decades worth of hardware.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And she's coming out. She's making a new
book. Yeah.
So, and then it's going to be a new movie, too.
Mm-hmm. Probably a new game.
And a new game.
Yeah, probably a new game.
It's going to be called, what is it? What's the name of that book called?
The Sun. Like
Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them, the game.
Oh, my gosh.
I want to give a shout out to How to Train Your Dragon, the game, on the DS. Game?
Really?
Yes. Not because I played it, and I have never played it. I have not. I don't know how it looks like. I don't know how it plays like. But I gave that to my niece and nephew as a Christmas present because I'm a cheap uncle.
They used
it. And they played it. And then, because here's the thing, at least I know how to read the back of the box. And so when it says any game that says download and play, which is like single cart, not multi cart, but single cart download and play, mm-hmm. that's when you want to get the kids because you can get one to them, and so they'll be able to play with their brother and sister with the download and play. And then
downloadable play. That's the greatest thing ever made.
Yes, that's fun.
Mario Kart and
Mario Hoops 3-on-3, a good game to remake.
That was so much fun. Mario that was such Hoops, a fun game. 3-on-3. It was just a DS.
That was for the GameCube.
No,
that was Super Mario Strikers. That was a good one, too.
The baseball one?
The soccer one.
The soccer one is fun, too. Yeah.
Sluggers is the baseball
Sluggers, yeah.
That one was pretty fun, too.
Shout out to all the Mario sports games.
Yeah, they're all great. Olympics, they're all good. The Olympics one, even those are fun.
Tennis. Fun.
Mario Golf for the 64 was good. I enjoyed it.
Go all day about Mario games. Yeah. How good they were. Sorry, I was thinking of 3-on-3, and I just... Yeah. Yeah.
That's a fun one.
I jumped topics, my bad.
No, fun. All right, let's call it here. Ladies and gentlemen, that has been another episode of the Musing with Menchaca Show. So if you like the video, give us a thumbs up, share us with your friends, and subscribe for more content. Let's see here. Plug. Smash or Pass 2016, June 18th. Let's see here. What else? Like, share, subscribe. Twitter, @chocolaca88. Mr_ChrisApricot. Booty flake.
Booty underscore flake.
Israel.
Israel DG97.
DG97. It's all right here on the bottom of the screen. you guys can read. Yes. By the way, you know what? I want to, just before I sign off, I want to ask you a quick question that I meant to bring up in the interview portion. First off, two things. Why booty flake and why, how, what was the tweet that made you famous on Twitter?
Okay, so booty flake comes from, there's an episode of SpongeBob where, hold on, if y'all give me a chance to speak, there's, like, it's SpongeBob, like, flying across the sky, because, like, he has, like, inflatable pants, and, like, when he flies over, like, he, like, makes a rainbow. And then, like, they're, like, these, like, stars, like, coming from the rainbow.
Okay.
And this fish on the bottom eats one of the stars.
Oh, my God. And so that was a booty flake?
Yes.
That was...
He ate a booty flake, yes. And then one tweet I made was that song 23 by Miley Cyrus, great song, where she says, Jay's on my feet. Mm-hmm. I put JJ the jet plane on my feet as shoes.
Oh my God. I remember that one. Yeah. It was hilarious.
And that made you blow up on Twitter and got you thousands of Twitter followers?
Yeah, exactly.
God damn it.
Yep.
JJ the jet plane's on my feet.
Okay.
There's another tweet. Yeah, there's another one. My mom, I asked my mom for Neosporin and she gave me this like cream and it was like anti-anal itch. And I was like, oh, thanks, mom.
Yeah. Oh my God.
I underlined it. I was like, thanks, mom.
You tweeted that and then also got you more followers?
Yeah.
Damn. Shit, I need to stage some tweets, man. Yeah. I need to read my script.
I'll retweet your stuff, yeah.
Yes. All right.
Give me your account.
Give me your account info.
No, I need you to ghostwrite my tweets for me is what I need.
Yeah,
to.
Yeah, okay. I can do that. Yeah,
thank you. Okay. I'll give you my login and password later.
Yeah, okay.
All right. So let's see here. Yeah, download the MP3 on iTunes. It's in the description below. And PSN, Nintendo Network, XBL, Twitch, Chocolocky 88. All across the board, easy to remember. And remember, if Twitter's character limit is not enough for you, I understand. We got the email, boomchakalaka4@gmail.com, for anything long form you want addressed for, you know, on the show. Shout outs, all that kind of stuff, all that good jazz. And remember to comment below with any suggestions for topics, reactions, feedback, all that jazz. Thank you very much, Israel, Clemente, and Christian, for doing the show. You guys are awesome. Had a good time.
It's been fun.
It's been fun.
Yeah.
I enjoyed it.
Yes.
I always enjoy it.
Thank you very much, audience, for making this a part of your day. I am your host, Lewis, signing out.